Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on how to load a sample report from Bold Reports report server in a Blazor Server application. Before getting into the procedure, let's take a look at the Bold Report Server. The Report Server is a report management studio provided by SyncFusion that allows users to create, manage, and share reports securely and easily. Our Report Server provides a built-in REST API service that helps you display the server's reports. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a Blazor Server application and the steps to load an already published SSRS RDL report from the Bold Reports report server. Before getting started with the Bold Report Viewer for Web, make sure your development environment includes the following: Visual Studio 2019 with the ASP.NET and web development workloads, .NET Core 3.1 framework. First, let's see how to generate the personal access token from the report server. To generate the personal access token, first, you need to log into the Bold Reports report server. You will see the list of reports that are published to the report server. To generate the personal access token, I click the user emoji icon in the left navigation bar. Then I click the user profile. We will be redirected to the My Profile page. I click the Personal Access Token in the top panel. In the Personal Access Token page, I click the Generate Token button. A confirmation dialog is displayed to generate the Personal Access Token. Click the Yes button. We will see the bearer token is displayed in the Authentication Token text box. Click the Click to Copy button to copy the generated access token. Next, let's create a Blazor Server application. Open Visual Studio 2019. And click Create a New Project. I choose Blazor Server App. And then click Next. If this template is not available, refer to the link in the video description to configure the system environment. I change the project name to Blazor Report Viewer. And then click Next. I choose the target framework as .NET 5.0. And then click Create. The default Blazor Server application is created. Now, let's initialize the Report Viewer control. In this section, we are going to integrate Bold Reports JavaScript controls by creating an interop file to initialize the report viewer with basic parameters. Create a class file inside the data folder and name it boldReportViewerOptions.cs. In the Bold Report Viewer Options class, I declare variables for storing the report service URL. Report server URL. Service authorization token. And report path. Create a folder named scripts in the www root folder. Create a bold reports interop.js file inside the scripts folder. Add the following code snippet to invoke the bold report viewer JavaScript control. Let's reference scripts and a theme. In this video, I am using CDN links to reference scripts and a theme, but you can also use local references. I have included an FAQ link for them in the description for this video. Open the _host.cshtml page from the pages folder. And reference the online CDN links along with the bold reports interop.js interop file in the head section to use our JavaScript reporting controls in the Blazor application. The purpose of each script and stylesheet is explained in the following table. Bold.reports.all.min.css includes the CSS properties for the JavaScript reporting component. The jQuery 1.10.2 script is used to render the SyncFusion JavaScript reporting widgets. ej2base.min.js, ej2data.min.js, ej2pdfexport.min.js, and ej2svgbasemin.js are used to render the gauge item. ej2linearGauge.min.js renders the linear gauge report item. ej2circularGauge.min.js renders the circular gauge report item. ej2maps.min.js is used to render the map report item. ej.chart.min.js renders the chart report item. bold.reports.common.min.js, bold.reports.widgets.min.js, and bold.reportviewer.min.js are required to render the bold reports report viewer. Open the index.razor file from the pages folder. Replace the following code to inject IJS runtime and invoke this JavaScript interrupt with the created report viewer URL in the index.razor file from the pages folder. This enables us to view the report from the report server using our report viewer control. The div element represents the container for the report viewer control. Inside the div element, I assign the ID and style attributes. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the HTML element. For this demo, I assign the value report viewer to the ID attribute. The style attribute is used to add the inline style for the div element. For this demo, I have assigned the width and height of the div element. Inside at code method, I create an object to access the bold report viewer options class. I initialize the render report viewer method. The render report viewer method is used to render the bold report viewer control in the Blazor page. Inside the render report viewer method, I initialize the value for report service URL. The report service URL specifies the web API service URL. The service URL contains the server name, service name, and REST API name. The format of the report service URL is http://reportserver-name/reporting/report-service/api/viewer. In this demo, I have hosted the report server on my local machine. So I have specified the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which I am hosting it. You can use your own report server name. Reporting/report-service represents the service name of the report server. API/viewer represents the web API name of the report server. Then, I initialize the value for report server URL. The report server URL specifies the server name and site information. The format of the report server URL is http://reporting/api/site/site name. In this demo, I have set the report server name as localhost along with the port number in which it is hosted. You can use your own report server name. Site/site1 represents the site from which we are going to load the report in the report viewer control. Since I have kept my report in site1, I specified site/site1. You can specify your own site's name. Then, I initialize the value for service authorization token. The service authorization token specifies the personal authorization token, which is already copied from the report server. Then, I initialize the value for report path. The report path specifies the path in which the RDL report file is published in the report server. Here I am using the sales order detail RDL report from the server location. This report is published in the sample reports category. I enter the invoke void async method, which invokes the render viewer JavaScript function asynchronously. Then I enter the on after render method for initial rendering of the bold reports report viewer control. Save the file. To preview the report, build and run the application. You will see the sales order details report is loaded in the bold report viewer. Let's briefly cover the procedure for loading a report from the cloud report server. The steps that need to be followed are the same but the report service URL and the report server URL will differ based on your cloud server configuration. I have shared our cloud reporting sample report service URL and report server URL separately in the video. Since the service for cloud reporting is hosted separately, reporting/report service is not set in the report service URL. And since multi-tenancy is not supported in the cloud reporting server, the site information is not required in the report server URL. You also need to generate the service authorization token from the cloud report server and add it in the application. And the path of the report, we want to render in the report viewer. I have provided the documentation link in the video's description for your convenience. In this video, we learned how to load a report server report in a Blazor server application using the report viewer control. Stay tuned to this channel for our upcoming videos on bold reports. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.